My refrigerator is not freezing. Our refrigerator, well, the freezer side doesn't freeze and the refrigerator side doesn't cool down. So I'm trying to figure out what the heck is wrong with this thing. What I did right now is I opened the back panel down here to look at my compressor. The compressor is humming. I don't know if it's really working, but it's humming, so it's doing something. So at least it's on. I replaced that fan just recently too, because the other one was bad. So that fan is doing its job. And these are fairly clean. Hold on. Okay. Now, for the most part, I don't see, you know, like clogged with dust or anything like that. So I'm sure that is doing its job. And like you see, the fan is turning. The compressor is humming. You can feel it and it feels warm. So I believe it's doing its job, because that means the relay is working. So I can't remove it because everything has got copper piping that have to be cut. I'm still questioning the compressor. The reason why is this. Let me go to the front. Okay, what I basically did is I disassembled the inside of the freezer, but I had to leave it plugged in order to get the unit to operate. The fan over here is spinning, so that's doing its job. The coils down here, I can touch them, and they feel cool, but they're not freezing, but they're cool. I mean, it's like I can touch it, but if I freeze this, it should be a lot colder, I would think. So I'm kind of questioning if the compressor is driving this enough, or, you know, what's going on. So like I said, it's still either I lost some gas somehow, or the compressor is bad. It's got to be one of the two. That's where I'm at. Anyways, the air is coming out, but it's, you know, it's not that cold. It's cool. That's about it. I can feel the temperature on that. I'm going to put a gauge on it and see what the temperature is. I'm still waiting. Lift this in for a little while, but you can see the temperature. In the freezer, it's just like 70 degrees. So with the door closed. So even though the fan is running, you know, it's not doing its job. Yeah. Alright, looks like I got all the stuff that I need for charging up my refrigerants in my refrigerator. I bought some stop leak from the auto store, R134A, which is what the fridge, my refrigerator uses. I have this from the last time I charged the van, this hose with the gauge, so that's cool, that's going to come in handy. My little gauge, my piercing valve and adapter, it's going to go together. This goes with the refrigerant, will go here, that goes over there. So that's what I'm going to do to put together. This is how it will go. Okay, I'm behind my refrigerator. You see I'm using some safety glasses as well. Just the things are under pressure. I don't want to take any chances of anything spraying out or something weird happening. So it's best to always be safe. And I'm looking over here at my compressor and some of the plumbing here. I'm debating where I'm going to tap into my new valve here. I've got to tap into one of these. I'm thinking maybe probably over here as a possibility, or here. So this has the best access right now, you know, in terms of that would be the actually the input, because the output is over here that comes close into the condenser. So I'll prepare. That's what I forgot to mention on my piercing valve. When it comes to make sure that it fits properly on the valve, they got these attachments in case of you have a different size pipe over here. And so I wanted to double check. And it seems like this one here, is since by itself is kind of big, this one seems to be the best fit. And anyways, I'm going to have to put a light on there. Hold on. Okay, as you can see, just this alone, the other side of the piercing valve is kind of big. So that's why they have these little attachments, which I'm going to try them out. And I was choosing this one. You can attach to this as part of the clamping. This one seems to fit the best. There we go. Just kind of give you an idea. So I'm going to be using this as part of that so it clamps securely either there or here. Here would be where they would charge it, so I might consider this one as easy access if it doesn't get in the way of the cover. I kind of like this one better. We'll see. Okay, I decided to choose this section here. I clamped it, as you can see. It's nice and snug. There's three screws to clamp it. And anyways, you tighten them kind of, you know, a little at a time, each one, so it's nice and even pressure. And anyways, it's the best location because I can reach the port right here, and the screws are right there. That was the best spot. I could have done it here, but the port would be sticking out away in the cover. And here it was kind of a snug fit, and looks like we're way back there, and I didn't want to deal with that. So this seems to be the best spot. There's my little adapter right there that I'm going to use. And it's just nice, like a tire valve, so to speak. So I'll be attaching my hose to that. But first, I'm going to get ready to pierce it with that center screw. Little by little. Snug. Okay. I believe I punctured it. When you turn it and turn it, you hear a boom sound, and that's pretty much it. So I'm going to keep it closed, and I'm going to attach the valve, this hose here, with the gauge on this side. You can see it's nice and snug. That way I can see my gauge. And I'm going to turn it back and make the... I just want to see what the pressure is right now on this thing. So provided I did this correctly, it should be okay. So I'll back it up a little bit at a time. Okay, I backed it up and I have a pressure of 10. I'm gonna try to get into the green, so I'm gonna be charging it up. So it is got pressure, but it's low. So hence the charging will be commenced. Okay, just to give you a setup, before I turn it on, this valve here, I just want to show you how I set it up. I already put it on, and it's ready to charge. Before I release the valve, I am told to go ahead and run the compressor, according to one of the YouTube videos, so that it's circulating. It gives me more of an idea where I'm at. Right now, it looks like it's reading zero now that it's running, so I'm going to go ahead and, now that it's running, the compressor is running, I'm going to go ahead and charge it. You know, as I'm running it, it seems like, you know, it's kind of flaky. It seems like right now it's up from 10 to 20, getting ready to go into green. And, I have it on right now and it's loading and I'm running it, so I expect it to drop a little bit. And I'm just going to keep feeding it, at least until it gets to the green, or at least it stabilizes at the green. That's my goal here. And then I'm going to let it go at that. Let me see if I just crank this up a little bit. So yeah, I bring it up. Like I said, this is the return line I tapped into. So it's pulling it in little by little. I think it's going to be a little slow process. And it feels nice and cold. I know it's going in. It's just a little slow because it's just a tiny valve opening there. And right now it's sitting about 20. The manual says 175 grams. Which is like half of this bottle, really, because this is like a 340 grams, I believe. So, you know, I obviously can't use the whole thing. Yeah, I close it up and I tighten it down. I'm gonna leave that there for a little bit, but I'm gonna let it run and see if it actually cools down the fridge. You know, if it starts getting colder and colder, then I think I'm gonna be good. If not, like I said, we'll have to have it tested out, see if it's leaking somewhere. And this one comes to stop leak, you know, I hope it'll. If there's any tiny leak somewhere, I'm hoping it'll take care of it. Yeah, I think that's as far as it's going to go. A little past 20. Remember, it was like around 10, so I charged it up to that. I can't seem to get any more gas in there, so I think that is as far as it will go, and that's all I'm going to be doing right now. It's probably just the design of this system here, so we'll see what happens. There's still plenty of stop leak left in the bottle, actually. Not plenty, but you could feel it. It's nice and icy cold, too, so the gas didn't go in. Anyways, I closed the valve there. This stays permanently. You don't take it out. You can remove the little adapter if you want. It because that's not necessary anymore. As long as you close the valve and over here, you're okay. It comes with a little cap, so you can put that on for now. Or you can leave that little adapter on. The choice is yours at this point. You know, you might want to use it for future though. So just go and just crank this baby on there. And all I can do is wait and wait and wait. It's going well. You see, like I said, the refrigerator, you know, cools down like it should. And I'm hoping it will. And that's pretty much it. Well, it seems like I'm successful in my fridge. As we can see, if you look over here, the temperature is at 40 degrees Fahrenheit, which is good. I put some stuff in already. I put a cup of water. It's frozen solid. Woo! Man, that's what I'm talking about. So I fixed it. And I still have a little bit of the R134 left. I think I'll use it in my van. I got to charge it up anyways, at least the rest of it. Then I could return that bottle for a $10 rebate. So I'm good with that. And looks like we're back in business again. One little fan that died earlier and just charged the system. Fridge is back in operation. Hope you all enjoy my little video.